So in this concept, we are giving some input in the first screen and it has to go to the second screen. So when we have to go to the second screen, we need to display the data. But at this point of time, in this exercise which we are doing right now, we'll just go to the second screen and type some output, type some text, okay? Go to the second screen. So in the second exercise, what we'll do is we'll make sure that we get the display of data in the second screen, okay? As of now, we are just moving to the second screen, but we'll be printing the data in the next exercise. Okay? So we'll just creating a Web Dynpro application here. Okay, let me come back from the beginning. So let me go back and start from the beginning. We have to just type, we have to get into SE80 transaction. And in SE80 transaction, normally we'll be here. A package or something will be there. So we need to select this Web Dynpro interface. We need to select this Web Dynpro interface and then we need to go ahead with the our new Web Dynpro interface details. Click on display. Do you want to create? Yes. And in this, we'll go for Web Dynpro application. New Web Dynpro application. And in this, we'll go for this main and say okay. View name is main. Fine. Say okay. You can change that name as well. So we have this main window. So we have got this view, a basic view is main window, and we'll go for the create and basic view. So we'll create a basic view here and basic view, select that, and I've just given it as basic, just name of the view name is basic, and we'll go to the context. In the context, we'll add some fields. So here we want to add the fields from the MAST table. So right click on this and create and a node, and in this we'll go ahead with MAST table. So this is MATLR. So we'll right click on this and we create node, and this we can say just node 1. For MAST and add attributes from structure and I'm selecting just WIRKS because we want to give the WIRKS value in this main screen and want to display the data in the next screen. So for that we'll go to the layout. In the layout we have these options here. So in the layout, we'll right click on this, insert your element. As I told you, we can also drag and drop them. But at this point of time, on this screen, the drag and drop was not working. So I'm doing it from this way. So we have this, and we'll go for this one is something like input. So this is an input field. This is an input field. So we can go for, first we wanted to give the text, right? So we'll go for label. First we'll go for label, and the label will go enter a, let's say I'll go for plant. Just plant. Okay, in this we have to give the text. What text you want, you can give it here. Text will give it as plant, and then we'll go for binding. So we have to go for this binding. So in this, like we have selected this, we just click on save now, and this plant has come. Now we'll go for input field. So right click on this, insert element. In this we have to go for input field is like, you know, we'll go for plant again, or we can also go for IP1, input one. Okay, whatever it is, anything is okay. So we'll go for input field. So I'll select this input. Input field, and just say okay. And then we need to go for the binding here. Value. So we need to go for the binding. So for the binding, we'll select this as WARKS here. And the binding happened. Now we'll right click on this. Okay, so after the binding happened, we need to also make sure that we have the outbound plug also has to be created. So when outbound plug has to be created when we are creating the push button. Okay, so that button, whatever button we are creating, right click on this and click on this insert element. Then we go for button. So button is like, you know, continue. We have written as continue. Continue. So we go for this continue here. Button. Say okay. And then we'll write this text. Go ahead with the text. Text will write this. Continue. And then we'll go for this on field on action. So on action, we have to click on this on action. On action, and we get this pop-up. In this pop-up, we'll go for action. Action is we gave something like submit. Anything is okay. Okay, so here you know, for a change, we can also move to second screen. Then we'll go for outbound plug. Outbound plug is not there, so we'll go for submit only here. Select OK. And do you want to create the outbound plug? Yes, say yes. So the outbound plug has been created here, and you can see that outbound plug is created. This is the next to go to. Next bit, say OK. Save. This is save, and once it's been saved, this happens to be the outbound plug. So outbound plug, I gave the description here. Now this outbound plug happens to be there in the first screen. Okay, and when you click on this continue, that outbound plug gets triggered. Now we'll go to the main screen, a main view, in which we have to get the final output. So as of now, in this exercise, I'm just giving a text element. Text to we'll go for label. Label and say what should come the text is. This is second screen. Okay, and then click on save. This is second screen. Okay, so for this we need to go for inbound plug. So inbound plug, we'll give some inbound plug. We need to give some inbound plug. We'll give it as a, this is a inbound plug name is second screen, and we don't have any outbound plug here. Save. And once it's been saved, what we can do is we can go ahead with the windows, and this is the component controller. So in the window, we have will by default will have this main window will be there. So we'll right click on this and create. So we'll go for embed view, and we'll select the view name. That's the second view that we have, basic view. So select that, and those details will come here, and say okay. Now here, this is the second one. This is a submit. So for the submit, when you click on submit, we'll go for create navigation link, and in the navigation link we'll give for the destination view. The destination view happens to be second view. So when you click on it, it should go to the second view. That's a main view. Select the main view. Inbound plug happens to be the second. So just say okay, and that's it. So this binding has been done now. Okay, so this is done. The binding is done now. So click on save. And now we need to create a Web Dynpro component. Right click on this. Create Web Dynpro application. Now, when we right click on this, we need to activate by right clicking on the object, Web Dynpro object name here. Create Web Dynpro application is what we need to do that. So we need to create a Web Dynpro application here. So we'll go for create Web Dynpro application. And this will start with set V2 Web Dynpro application. Say OK and activate. Now, once it's been created, you double click on this object name, say yes. And save it again in the Web Dynpro application. Say OK. Now right click on this Web Dynpro application and click on activate. So we need to activate all these things together. So once it's been done, we'll double click. So until and unless you create this Web Dynpro application, it's not possible to execute this. So we have this 10111. So execute this. Log on. Okay, I'll just need to fix this. Label is empty for this text. Okay, and one more thing is when we go into this window, we need to make this basic one as a default. So basic has to be default. Right click on this and set it as default. That's very important because that should populate there. So let's go ahead with the right click on this. Activate. Say okay. Now once it's active, we'll select this one and execute. So I just give this ID 1, and now we'll go back and activate it again. So don't do syntax check until you activate everything, because overall, you know, individual syntax check will not work here. So we need to make sure that everything is closed here. Double click on this. It's done. So we'll go back to this Web Dynpro application. Execute. So we have this basic screen. Click on. You can give anything. Doesn't matter what you give here, because we have done the binding with the continue. So this is the second screen. So it got into the second screen. This was the exercise that we wanted to do. So this completes the exercise one. In the next exercise, what we'll do is when we click on that related to that plant, we should get the details in the second screen. Is what we'll do it in the next assignment.